In this video, we'll show you how to enable automatic user provisioning for Salesforce.com. Enabling automatic user provisioning for an app consists of these five common steps in the Azure Management Portal. Step one, select your application from the gallery of supported apps or from your list of existing enterprise apps if it is already enabled for single sign-on. Step two, configure user and group assignments, which define who should be provisioned and have access to the applications. Step three, give the user provisioning service credentials needed to connect to your application's user management API. Step four, configure attribute mappings, which define how existing users should be matched between Azure AD and the app and what user attributes should be synchronized between the two. And step five, turn on the provisioning service. In this demo, we'll show how to perform these steps using Salesforce.com as the application. Here I am signed into the Azure Management Portal as a global administrator. I'm in the Azure Active Directory section in the Enterprise Applications Blade. If I were adding Salesforce for the first time, I will use the gallery experience, which can be accessed through this button here. I would find Salesforce in the list of supported applications and I would add it. Since I've already added Salesforce in my Azure Active Directory tenant, I will simply find it in my list of existing applications. The first step is to assign the users and/or groups that I would like provisioned to Salesforce. I do this by going to the Users and Groups tab. Here I can see a list of users and groups that are presently assigned for both single sign-on and provisioning, and I will add a new user by clicking the Add User button. I'll use this control to find and select a user that I want to bring in scope for provisioning, and click Select. The next step will be to assign the Salesforce role that I want the user to be provisioned as. Here, I'm going to select Chatter-Free User. And then I click Assign. And this user has now been assigned to Salesforce for both single sign-on and automatic user provisioning. To configure provisioning, I'll click on the Provisioning tab. The first step is to provide the Azure AD provisioning service with Salesforce administrative credentials that it needs to connect to the Salesforce User Management API. I'll provide my Salesforce administrative username, password, secret token, as well as the URL to my Salesforce tenant in this form. To get the secret token, I will go to the Salesforce portal and retrieve it from the My Personal Information area. If there are any questions about how to retrieve any of the information required in the administrative credentials section, you can learn about this in the documentation for the Salesforce Provisioning Connector, which can be found on this website under the App Integrations Tutorial section. Once I've entered my credentials, I'll click Test Connection. And it worked. I can optionally enter a notification email. I can automatically receive updates if there are any problems with these credentials and the provisioning service ability to connect to the provisioning API. My next step will be to configure attribute mappings, which will define how user data flows from Azure Active Directory to Salesforce.com. I'll do this by clicking on Synchronize Azure AD Users to Salesforce here. I'll scroll down to set my attribute mappings. Here, I can decide which attributes flow from Azure Active Directory into which Salesforce attributes in the column on the right. The most important mapping is the mapping between the user principal name in Azure AD to the username in Salesforce. If a user is assigned in Azure AD and their user principal name does not exist as a Salesforce username, a new account will be created for that user. If the user principal name matches an existing Salesforce username, then the provisioning service takes over management of that account and can make updates to it. To save my attribute mappings, I'll click the Save button. And then finally, to turn on the provisioning service, I'll set provisioning status to on and click Save. Once provisioning is turned on, the service performs an initial synchronization which retrieves the list of users from Azure AD, filters the users based on assignments and scoping filters, and then synchronizes users to the target application. Once this initial synchronization is complete, the provisioning service then goes into incremental sync mode, where it only makes changes to the target app based on changes to the assigned users detected in Azure AD. This can include detecting and provisioning a newly assigned user, updating user attributes such as names, roles, or contact information when the corresponding attribute changes in Azure AD, or disabling access when the user is unassigned from the app in Azure AD. For more detailed information on all operations performed by the provisioning service, please refer to the URL shown on the screen. To monitor and troubleshoot user provisioning, see the summary report in the Provisioning tab of the Azure portal. This shows the state of user provisioning for a selected app and provides a link to the audit logs, which capture and record all actions performed by the provisioning service. In this next demo, we'll show how to use the audit logs to confirm that a user was successfully provisioned. Back on the Provisioning tab, I can see the Summary Status Report underneath the Synchronization Details section. It shows me that I have successfully synchronized 3 users and when the synchronization was last run. To view the audit logs, I'll click the link below. To verify that a user was successfully provisioned, I will type the user principal name of the user, or the first part of it. And this gives me a list of all provisioning actions executed against this particular user. Here I can see that this user, Apasani, was retrieved from Azure AD, and then it was retrieved successfully from Salesforce, and then an update operation was performed by the provisioning service. I can click on the details to see which attributes were updated. Here it shows me that the employee number was detected as modified in Azure AD, and we changed the employee number to this number in Salesforce.com. In the next video, we'll provide tips for rolling out automatic user provisioning to an application.